बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलाम अलैकुम वरहमतुल्लाहि बरकातुहु। जुज नंबर 23, जस्ट वी आर गोइंग अ रिव्यू ऑफ ओवरऑल समरी ऑफ दिस सूरा, ओवरऑल समरी ऑफ दिस जुज नंबर 23। एंड इन दिस वी गोइंग टू लर्न हाउ द डिफरेंट नेशंस एंड हाउ प्रॉफिट्स हैज बीन सेंट। And it continues with Suratul Yasin. نحمده نصلي على رسوله الكريم أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. So here in this surah, we learn this surah was revealed during the last stage of Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam residence in Mecca. And Quran is revealed by Allah to warn the people and establish a charge sheet against the disbelievers. And Allah has created all things in pairs. Everything is created in pairs. Allah is only one. The day, the night, and the moon, all are being regulated in Allah by this, all are obedience towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Night and day, they are coming on the time. And Allah's greetings to the residents of Jannah. And Allah addressed to the criminals, the sinners. So here the Surah Yasin continue with Juz number 23. In Ayah number 22, how a Rajul Momin, he running and he convey the message. And how he convey, he was so much concerned for the people. When he was murdered and he entered Jannah, and still he was concerned about the people, how other people will be, they should know what is the correct religion, the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He was concerned about that. And in Suratul Yasin, we learn that the things will be with the people, the one generation after another. And how different fruits, different livestock, and so that we will be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When we eat, we should be thankful to Allah, not ungrateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah will send the provision for a time. Allah knows when to send what. And the horn will be blown, means nufikha fissur. This sur will be for the second time. And once from the grave to their Lord, they will hasten. And this will be the second time. And they will say, woe to us, who has raised up from our sleeping place? Their reply will be, this is what the Most Merciful had promised. Because they were sleeping. And then mention about the hellfire, which was promised. And they will enter to burn there. For what you used to deny. They deny Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But that day, Allah will seal their mouth. And their hands will speak. And their feet will testify about what they used to deny. In the hadith, we learn that when you will be brought on the day of judgment, your mouths will be sealed. And the first thing to speak from your body. And what you will be speak, the thighs, the palm of your hand, it would be said to the thighs, flesh, bones to speak, and his thighs, flesh and bones will bear witness to his deeds. So we should be scared what we are doing, whether we hide or whether we show. Nothing is hidden from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And to whom Allah granted life, then reverse the creation, means a person become weak when he or she go through the old age. The old age is person become like a child. And Surah Safat, it's a longer surah. In this also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the surah was revealed in the last stage of the middle Makkan period, where the prophets and companions were passing through very difficult and discouraging circumstances. Allah himself testifies that your God is one, and shaitan do not have any access to the exalted assembly of angels. Life after life in the hereafter and the day of judgment, and dialogue between the followers and the leaders, and the simple how heaven and earth was created, and it was very simple for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So in this we learn, how Safa the Safa, in this we learn how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, everything, angels, they line up in rows, and how drive the clouds, and those who recite the message, the angels are being mentioned over here. The fact that they form rows, and this is a fact that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling us about the angels form rows in the sky. In a hadith, we learned that Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, he once came out of to the companion and said, will you not form rows as angels do before the Lord? They said, how do the angels do that? He said, they complete the first row and fill the gaps in the rows. So we have to make the rows, that how the angels would be doing. And also we learn protection against every rebellious devil, because shaitan is an open enemy. One have to protect ourselves. And the people who deny, they will surrender on the day of judgment. But except illa ibadullahi mukhlasin, but not the chosen servant of Allah. Means those will have a provision determined, and they will be given the honored, because they will be honored and in gardens of pleasure. We learn in a hadith, once a man asked Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam about a certain tree in Jannah. So he explained that each tree will have in a place of thorn something like a pouch. In dunya will have a thorn, but there no, it will be a pouch that will be filled with 70 different kinds or colors of fruits, each being unique and different from the other. And you know how the people will be sitting facing one another. In dunya we want to sit that way, right? And they will be sitting on comfortable couches, and they will be circulated among them a cup of wine from a flowing spring. And they will be circulated among them a cup of wine from a flowing spring, and wide, glistening, delicious to the drinkers. Such a delicious thing. But you have to strive hard in this world. And those who return to hellfire, and they found their father's ashtray, so they hasten to follow their footsteps. So you can't follow your forefathers, whatever they are doing. And we learn how Ibrahim al-Islam conveyed the message. He asked, he did the tabligh, and he was looking the star, and how he conveyed the message to his own father. And he said he broke the idols, and he asked, bigger idol, break it. They said, no, it can't move, it can't do anything. Then he said, why don't you believe in oneness of Allah? When it don't move, it don't do anything. Then we learn about the dua of Ibrahim al-Islam, Rabbi habli minas salihin. We should also make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to have a righteous children. Even though he was old, but he asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah gave the righteous good tidings of a bearing boy. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tested Ibrahim al-Islam one after another. He blessed him with the Ishaq and descendants and the doer of good. Clearly, this is a blessing for Ibrahim al-Islam, and how he was righteous. Even their descendants were righteous. Ibrahim al-Islam, their son, were righteous people. How they were tested, but they were muhsineen. And we also want to be muhsineen. And in Surah As-Saffat, we learn how they will be given the greeting, salam, for all the prophets. One prophet, another prophet, one after another prophets are mentioned, and they were given salam. Salam is a peace, and also it's a dua. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala again and again mention about the chosen servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And those who line up for the prayer, like Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, there is not a space of 1 foot or hand span in the sky, except that there is an angel over there prostrating or standing in prayer, in praising to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And indeed, we are those who exalt Allah. We should proclaim the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We should do a lot of tasbih. And Suratul Sawad, Sawad, Wal Quran is Zil Zikr. In this, it was mentioned, this Quran is a zikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Suratul Sawad, according to some tradition, this surah was revealed in the fourth year of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, after Umar embraced Islam, which after the migration to Habasha. Yet other tradition indicates that it was revealed during the last illness of Abu Tala, and the 10th or 11th year. And Quran is full of admonition, story of people of different people and nation, and Prophet Dawud al-Islam was mentioned. And also story of Sulaiman al-Islam is mentioned in this. We get to learn so much from the different prophets and different nation. In this we see Quran is containing reminder, but those who disbelieve are in a pride and dissension, shikak. Shikak is to oppose someone, to refuse to believe, very, very stubborn in one's denial. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroyed generation and call out, it was not a time for escape. And also mention the religion, how they fabricated the people, those who deny, they didn't believe in it. And then the people of Nuh denied, how the nation, different nation, then Samud, Lut al-Islam, how they denied and disbelieved. And people, they hasten for the punishment. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, to isbir ala ma yakulu, to have sabr, to do sabr, you know, be patient what they say, and remember our servant Dawud al-Islam, because the possessor of strength, indeed he was the one who repeatedly turned back to Allah. So take a lesson from his life. Whenever we are going through tough time, we should go through the stories of Anbiya Ikram, especially Prophets, Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam and Prophet Dawud Alaihi Wasallam and different. So we get to learn so much, and how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave them so much blessing, like, you know, subjugated the mountains to praise with him and exalting Allah in the late afternoon and after sunrise, you know, making tasbih in the morning and afternoon. We learn that Dawud al-Islam, that Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said the recitation of the Zabur was made easy for him, and he used to order that his riding animals be saddled and would finish reciting Zabur before even they were saddled, and he would never eat except from earning of his own handwork, his own manual work. Like, he used to work and he would earn. And the birds were assembled all with him, repeating praise. And Allah gave him kingdom, gave the wisdom and beautiful speech. And then also talk about how he was given the power of decision. And when he was deciding about 99 female sheep, he was remembering his own mistake. What was that? It wasn't mentioned here. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says he realized and asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgiveness. And Dawud al-Islam, he became certain because he was tested and tried, and he understood that and he repent. And then we get to learn, like, every prophet, they were tested and they asked forgiveness. And also we learn how Sulaiman al-Islam was given so much blessing, but they were thankful. They were thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they were the people who are very thankful and righteous. And also we learn that Sulaiman and placed on his throne a body, means his own progeny, his own son, like he was yani his was paralyzed, and how he was given the authority over the jinn, how every builder and diver other bounds together in shackles, like, you know, this was the gift. Because he asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he made dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also mention about Ayyub al-Islam, you know, how he was tested and shaitan was touched him and hardship, torment. But he was asked to strike the ground with your foot. And there was a cool spring, a cool bath and drink. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asked him to have a drink from that water and it will cure you. So Allah gave the cure. It was the mercy from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah granted him family like before, more bigger family, and mercy and a reminder for understanding. He was given more and more, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave Ibrahim, Isaac, Yaqub, and how they were righteous servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah has like reveal everything with the truth. It was Haq. And Surah Az-Zumar. Zumar is another Makki Surah. It has 79 ayahs. The Surah was revealed in the early stage of Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam mission, before permission was granted to the Muslims who were being persecuted to migrate to Habsha. Some tradition provide the explanation that this verse was revealed for Jafar bin Talib and his companion when they made up their mind to emerge to Habasha. And the mushrikeen, those who worship someone else beside Allah. And on the day of judgment, no one shall bear the burden of others. Believers who cannot produce their faith should migrate to another place. So here in this we learn the revelation of the Quran is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the exalted and wise. And for Allah, this is a pure religion. This is this is the only religion. And also, if you disbelieve, Allah is free from need, because Allah don't need you. We need Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when adversity touches a person, he is very restless. He asks only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When adversity is removed, he becomes like as if nothing happened and start ascribing partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we are asked to do the sabr, because if we do sabr, Allah will give you without account. Sabr, like, you know, you have to do sabr, patience. Then sabr should be at Sadmatul Ula, when something strikes the person, that moment of time. And listen to speech and follow the best of it. Means Ibn Abbas said, this is the person who listened to all sorts of things, but he followed the best of the best. And Allah sends down rain, spring, and varying colors, how the vegetation, everything that was mentioned. And then Allah mentioned about how opens the heart for the Islam, whose heart are hardened against the remembrance of Allah, that they are in manifest error. So there are two type of people. One, someone whose chest is open for Islam. Other, whose heart is hardened. And Ibn Qayyim said there are cause, there are reason for this. Means we become of the first category. Like we want to have open our heart for Islam. So what are the key things? For Hidayah, for the Tawheed, we should make dua. Rabbi Shrahli Sadri. Dua of the ilm. All the duas of the Husunul Ilm. And also we should gain knowledge. And turning towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala again and again, repeatedly. And number four, remembering Allah consistently, whether it's Salah, Quran, Sunnah. Number five, treating people in a good way. Six, being brave in practicing Islam. Seven, cleaning the heart. It's like never-ending process. Eight, leaving useless things. May Allah save us all and protect us. Jazakallah khairan kaseera. Subhanakallahumma bihamdika. Nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta.